Excuse me, I'm Mr. DePietri, and nobody from his applicant is here, so we're waiting for them. We're going to have an issue. This meeting is going to get continued due to the fact that Lisa Capello's daughter got very sick this afternoon, and she can't attend the meeting. And that'll limit it only to three people, because we're already short by one. So this hearing is going to have to get continued until further notice we decide. But I have to wait for somebody from the applicant to be here before we can do that. So I don't know where they are either. Thing is, you might want to stick around till we make the final decision on what happened, because Lisa's going to text us, and if she can come, this hearing may get continued until the end of the night till we do our last, after we do our other agenda issues. So we need to find out where we're going to be. In a few minutes, we'll get some of it taken care of. Not much we can do about it, really. Excuse me, I am going to make a motion that we continue this public hearing until 8:15, 7:45 tonight. I need a second.
Second.
Okay, all in favor? Aye. Okay. So, that takes care of that until quarter of eight. Excuse me, say that again?
We don't know yet. We'll should know in another half hour or so, and we'll find out of where we're going to be going with all, and Mr. Petrie ain't here either, so until we find out what's going on. Yeah.
No, that's just stuff.
I get a woman's.
Right there.
You've reached. All right, then I'll leave a message.
That's just stuff.
It didn't pick up. No, it didn't pick up. It said that you've reached. It was a woman's voice, like you've reached the officer.
Three six two. That number. What I brought up was the recommendation of support of the new gentleman, Jeff Walker, for the alternate position. So, can we get a motion?
Yeah, I'll make a motion to accept the applicant as an alternate.
Okay, and a second?
I second the motion.
Okay, you've read the resume, I've read it, I think that everybody. So,
I think Jeff would be
okay, is everybody agreeable?
Good alternate, yes.
Okay. All in favor? Right. And so we write a letter saying that that we recommend that, what do you call? And you can put as an unanimous vote. That's all you put. The other thing is I have a letter here. One of these letters. Four letters, I know what to do. That Paul was appointed as a full-time position. And
all
did
right.
you... get sworn in under the full-time position, I hope.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yep.
Very good.
I've been sworn in. Yes.
And we have the letter. You guys get the letter from Jennifer. Don't read that. That's in this other package, but.
Mike accept the minutes? Can you guys accept the minutes?
No, we don't have enough of us here to really do it. Do you have copies of the minutes, guys? You've read the minutes?
Is that included in that packet? And
yeah.
I don't think I got the minutes.
I think it was an email. Not, I don't think it was in the package.
I didn't see.
It might have been an email.
It was in an email that way.
Oh, I don't think I saw it.
You have copies, give it to them. Well, all right. The thing is, what we've done is we've continued it until 7:45 due to the fact that Lisa Capello is not here. And if she doesn't, her daughter got sick, she's trying to get a babysitter. If she doesn't show up, we have an agenda at 7:30, which we'll entertain, and then we'll see where we're at 7:45, if she's going to show up or not. And then you need to make the decision on both hearings of what you want to do. What? Well, we have a quorum, but for the 40B project, I am not going to let it go forward with only three individuals. And the use variance, we have four people, which is your choice, where it's so that's going to be your call. So we'll wait until we get. That's what's going to happen, yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Can I see that? We're going to have to wait for Bobby to the next meeting to approve these minutes as much as, well, I suppose the three of us can approve them. I would like to get them approved due to the fact that we filed, oh, Tom's here, so we can't approve them under that. Get them done. Do you have a copy of these? Excuse me, Tom, I'd like you to come forward. This has been continued to 7:45. This hearing has, yeah. Lisa's not here. I want to do the minutes, approve these set of minutes, how you're here. Have you read those minutes? I presume after what you did all week, you must have at least read the minutes.
Yeah, they went back and forth.
I kept them brief.
Yeah, and that's what Aldo wanted.
But the minutes.
And the decision of oversee it anyways.
Oh, so these are the, the only thing I'm thinking is that, you know, Bill and I and Aldo went back and forth all week.
I know that.
So, I tend to think that the final statement of the condition should probably track what was there.
It does automatically, Aldo says.
What?
It automatically will track the minutes we approve, then the decision's on record for it anyways, and don't even have to stay it in the minutes.
But are these the conditions that the way I drafted them originally?
They're not, like? It's not a list
it's
of conditions just that
the,
overcaps.
It's just the overseeing
not,
of it.
It's not a,
you know, he doesn't,
document.
The major issue doesn't have to be, it's just the general.
Yeah, but this looks like the way I drafted them, which I think was fine, but it may be a little more rigorous than the way it turned out to be.
Yeah, and it'd be whatever.
So they're okay with that.
But then, yeah, and that'll go with, and I filed that this afternoon.
Okay. All
so
right. That's good. That's
all right.
Yeah.
Okay, so can we get a motion to approve the minutes for, let me see that for a minute, Tom.
September 17th.
For September 17th.
Yes.
Paul, you ready to?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead, Tom.
Move to approve the minutes from September 17th.
Second? All in favor? Aye. Okay. 7:30, we're going to do this other one.
Main Street, yeah.
Right, which is not going to happen. It's all screwed up.
Oh, really?
Yeah. The issue is, this is properly filled out.
Oh, yeah, gotcha.
We do not have a plan showing the apartment.
Know what you're doing, right?
See, that's all we've got.
Did you get a letter from the building inspector?
Yeah, right in the front. Karen, where I got it here someplace. And The other issue is, we're on ES, you need to turn your mic on. The other issue is, he was supposed to go in front of the planning board and didn't do it. So it's gotta be continued.
Yeah, but that, he didn't know.
What? Well, it doesn't matter, it's supposed to have been done, and you read the.
You want the letter from the building?
Yeah, just for a minute.
I'm just curious as to how he ended up coming here.
Yeah, just.
No, I don't need a copy, I'm just curious.
See, and Lisa missed that other meeting, I can't go forward with it either. Now, on the other hearing, you won't be sitting on that either, right?
On Park Central, no.
On either one of them?
Right.
Yeah, because Cumberland Farms is here.
Right.
For the use variance.
Right.
So it's up to him if he wants to try to go with four people or not. We just made a motion.
Where's Lisa?
What?
Where's Lisa?
What?
Where's Lisa?
Her daughter got sick this afternoon. She's trying to get somebody to babysit right now, and she's gonna text us, so I've continued it to quarter of. We just voted, just so you know. I don't know if you read the resume on Jeff.
Yeah, it didn't look like clearly, you voted to what?
To approve his appointment. I didn't know whether you were coming or not, but we needed to get it to the selectmen, so.
Sure.
It was an unanimous vote to approve his thing to.
Okay, cool.
What do you call? So, I think from reading the resume, I don't know him at all, but from reading the resume and everything, I think, you know.
I know people who know him, he's a developer.
We just, my only upside about it is.
Well, you know.
Yeah, that's why I asked him.
Oh, cool, all right.
My only upside about it is, I don't know, I think we're getting too many realtors. But that's all right.
I mean, he's not a realtor.
No, he's a developer, isn't he?
He's a builder, I mean.
But he was a commercial realtor, too.
He was a commercial realtor, and, you know.
Both, really.
His actual background is an engineer, well, was an engineer originally.
Right, so, it'd be good.
Now a builder developer.
Yeah, right.
So I think it'll be good for us.
He's a civil engineer, right?
I mean, you know.
Yeah, but I mean.
Out of college, yeah.
Yeah.
As long as he's not a broker, those brokers you can't trust.
Mm-hmm.
You can't trust those commercial brokers.
Right.
They're slippery.
They are slippery.
Okay, how we're doing, we've got some other issues to take care of. I'm going to agenda for our next meeting for the 29th of the month. Be the 29th of October. And the deadline for that public hearing will be on Monday. There's one applicant that's going to submit between now and Monday for it. So we'll do that for the 29th here at 7:00. And we have one applicant present, and we're gonna have some continuous, I think, before the night's over for it.
Can we start at 7:30?
What?
Any chance we can start at 7:30? So I can get my train out by.
No, we'll start at 7:00, but I'll put Park Central or something on at 7, so you don't have to be here.
Good
idea. All right, Tom?
Yeah.
It works for me.
Okay, the other thing is, November. What?
Yeah, October 29th.
October 29th. I'm going to, I want to schedule our next meeting for December 3rd.
Nothing in November?
No.
Why is that, just out of curiosity?
What?
Why is that?
Because I'm gone for the whole month.
You are?
Yes.
Are you really, for a month?
Yeah.
God, you don't know the routine.
Unless we have something that has to come up, I'll come back.
Something's good. What are you hunting?
It's hunting season.
Yes.
That's right. And then if we do December 3rd, we won't have to have our next meeting because it's December 3rd. We won't be meeting between Christmas and New Year's or anything anyways. And that's what we've done the prior years. As you know, we've done it in the beginning of December, the last 2 or 3 years. Then we don't have to meet at the end of the month or the 1st of January. And then I would say that our next scheduled meeting would be January 7th. It would be the week after New Year's. Does everybody go along with that?
That's fine.
All right, so Karen?
October 29th, December 3rd, and January 7th.
Yes, all right, 7:00 here.
Yep.
And if they, you know, who knows what'll be on the agendas or whatever, and if there's anything we come up in between that we might have to do, then we'll go forward with it. All right, I told Tom, you weren't here, we got a letter from the selectmen that they appointed Paul for full-time, and he did get sworn in and everything under that. We have the letter from Jennifer. I don't know if you read that from the 40B. right here. You can review that, and that'll come up.
Park Central, right?
Yeah.
That's not me.
Yet. Oh, you're not doing that anyways. That's right. I'm sorry. Okay. I got 3 minutes. I'm going to open the other public hearing. Do you have them? You got to read the thing in. So you can't do it because there's nothing here to read. Just read that one for now. Okay, I'm going to open up the hearing at 7:30 for Main Street. Is there anybody here representing them? We didn't have a good night tonight. I'm apologizing. We got 2 minutes to wait, so we'll have to wait the 2 minutes for that.
Not your night.
Jesus. Unbelievable.
Yeah. They're going up to the flag every 2 seconds.
Can we charge people for not coming to the meetings?
Well, we were talking about discipline. I know, you'd think to show up at your own hearing. We never really talked about actually that. We talked about filings and postponements and stuff.
So what do we do?
Something I do want to discuss. Karen, on the new applicants, have you guys printed up the new applicant for decision on the use variances and the way it's supposed to be defined that Mark wrote, we approved it. Did that get put into an application yet?
You mean with respect to the 10 days?
No, that change? The 10 days one thing, that's yeah. One issue. The other issue is the we highlighted the three high definition requirements for it. And Mark had wrote them, we approved them, and they were supposed to go into the new application form.
Yeah.
And I'm curious, I haven't seen that.
Yeah, he would have taken care of that. I could check with him.
Okay. The other thing is, Mark and I have talked, and we're going to consider hiring another secretary to help do legal notices and stuff. And we're going to hire, in the process, we're going to meet with Karen Bouvier. Karen was a secretary that was here for 10 or 12 years and did an extremely good job. She's a head secretary at the city of Marlborough, town of Marlborough, city of Marlborough, not town. And we've talked to her, and she's going to meet with us next week sometime, and I think she's going to do it. Karen will come in and do the minutes, and she'll help do the decisions, because that's what she's very, very good at.
I think she's doing the minutes as well.
What? She's no, Mark is not. That's not what Mark and I have decided. Okay. So, but she's going to take, and we're going to meet with her. Well, before we have our next meeting, it'll be settled, and we'll have, you know, it set up, which will help Karen a lot by doing it that way, and Tom too. I guess other than that, the two different things that get printed in our application, which I'm going to talk to Mark and make sure they get done. I don't have anything else that's pending that's right at the moment. Does anybody else have any questions or any?
No, not that I can pick up.
Okay. Can you check in the hallway for me and see if the applicant, see if a Main Street is here? Yeah.
Andrew.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is.
Excuse me, are you the applicant for Main Street?
Looking for your shirt.
Oh.
85 Main, right?
85.
That's Main Street. That's... Okay, Andrew, he's here. You want to come forward, please? Okay, we've opened a public hearing for Main Street. Karen, would you please, you sit down there, sir. Would you please read into it the, turn that on. Yeah.
Okay. 85 Main Street, accessory apartment, special permit. The applicant is seeking specific zoning relief for an accessory apartment as defined in section 174 5-8.2B1 of the Southborough Zoning Code.
Okay, sir, there's a microphone. You need to use that, please. This mic, you can take it with you. This one.
Sir, do you want me to introduce this, sir?
What?
What do you want me to say?
First, you introduce yourself, yes.
Sure.
Do you need to push the button?
Okay, so I'm Robert Horn, and I live on 85 Main Street, and when I bought the house about 8 years ago, the apartment over the garage was rented at that time, and that was one of the attractive points of buying the house. And it's been rented ever since then. And then recently, when my realtor put a sign out in front with a rent for rent sign, I guess it came to the notice that it was a violation of the zoning code, and that's why I've applied for the special variance.
Right. The reason is there was never a building permit pulled for the rental on the apartment. Okay, there's a few issues on this. One, the application that you filled out did not properly get filled out. It's not properly filled out, it's not properly signed. The other issue is we have a plot plan, but we need a drawing of the apartment, of the way it's built and everything. That's part of the regulation that you have to do. And the other issue is you have to go in front of the planning board first before you come in front of us to approve it. You go to the planning board, they'll make conditions, and then it comes in front of us, and then we make the final decision on it. And I don't know, I mean, Karen's very new at this and she's learning, but I'm not sure why you weren't told, apparently, that you weren't told you had to do that.
Yeah, because I spoke to Mark first.
Right, but you weren't told that you had to do that. No. So these things, they've got to be done. So the thing, so you need to get a design drawing of the apartment to go that we need. You need to get and go in front of the planning board. Now, in talking to Jennifer, if you call them tomorrow, I think you can get on their agenda for next week on a Monday night. But they're also going to need a drawing. So you talk to her about it. But they're going to need an engineering drawing showing the apartment itself, how it's built, and, you know, they've got one bedroom, two bedrooms, or whatever.
Yeah, so the photographs were insufficient.
Oh, yeah. No, it has to be an engineer drawing. I mean, the photographs, you can see the house. I've seen the house for many years. I know what it is. But we need to see if there's two accesses off of it and all that has to be. But it has to be done by an engineer.
Okay, as I understand, I understand what you're saying.
Use that mic, please.
When I spoke to Mark about this originally, he went over and actually looked at it and said that that was not necessary, just the photographs. And that's why I...
Yeah, well, no.
That.
Under the regulations of the town, we have to have that to approve it. So we got something to go by and something that has to go on file. And for him to give you a building permit, he needs something to go by to give you a building permit also. So the thing is, what we'll do is, if you request, we'll give you an extension to our next meeting, and hopefully you can clear all these issues up. By giving you an extension, you don't have to refile or do anything. This application, you have to take back and finish filling it out. Like under here, the description of why you're doing it didn't get done. Over here, anybody that's going to speak on it has to be put in here. Your application signatures on these parts weren't filed or anything. So that stuff all has to be done. And I mean, what you can do is come in and either see Mark or Karen during the week and have them double check it all. So, I mean, the thing is that Karen is new at all this year, and this is the first one of these we've had since she's been here, so she hasn't had an opportunity to review it, you know?
Yeah, no, I understand. As I say, I was guided by Mark.
Right, so. But that was so. I'm going to give you. We'll make a motion to continue this to our next meeting, which will be the 29th of October, on a Wednesday night. Okay, guys, you have any questions or anything else to add to this, other than what I said?
No, because the planning board's going to go over all that stuff. You know, septic. They're going to the health board of health. I guess is going to get involved.
Board of health is already. We talked to them today. They've already said they've approved. There's what, three bedrooms in the house?
In the house, yes.
Right, and one bedroom in the garage. So there's four bedrooms. The septic system is designed for four bedrooms.
Bedroom design.
So the Board of Health has no issue with
okay.
it. So there's no issues with that.
So this is just a special permit for accessory apartment. That's all it is?
Right, yeah. Gotcha.
What's the section on that again, Karen?
Pardon?
What's the section of the zoning code?
174? 174-82.
Oh,
it's on this one.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. I don't think I got that. Okay.
All right.
Are there any notices or anything that need to be submitted?
What do you mean?
Or like notices to abutters or?
Yeah.
The abutters right.
Where is the abutters?
Notified of the.
Excuse me, 1 minute. Where are the abutters list?
I get it right here.
And you have all the cards and everything. So that was all.
That's
done.
All been. That's all set. Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. So we need a motion to continue it until October 29th, and we'll do it at 7:30.
Perfect.
Yeah, can I ask this be
yes.
expedited? I have a potential tenant for November 1st. I understand there's a 20-day appeal process.
Right. What do you mean?
I mean, if you push it to the next meeting to October 29th, that
right,
means
that's
it's going to be
our next scheduled meeting.
It's going to be December 1st before I can get somebody in there.
Well, you have somebody in there now and the building.
No, I don't.
I thought the building inspector said there was.
No.
But there's nothing, I mean, we can't, you have to go to the planning board and get approved by them first, too. You might not get that done in their first meeting either. So our next agenda meeting, which we just filed, is for the 29th of the month.
Okay, so Mark's approval doesn't matter in this case?
What? No, not on this. We have to approve it.
Okay.
That's approved by the planning board first, and then sent to us, and then we do a final approval, and then we get to that point. Technically, I think if everything gets cleaned up and done, I don't see any major issue with it myself from what I've read. It's just a legal process that's the issue presently.
I understand. It's just, I followed what, as I said, what I was told, and it's, it costs me every month that it's not occupied.
Right. So it's, it's the thing. But even if you go through and read the application stuff, there is, it says what you're supposed to do and everything. So a little miscommunications, which I apologize for, but there's nothing I can presently do about that, and it just is the way it has to be done.
Okay, so I can come in, for instance, tomorrow and get the details and make the changes?
Yeah.
Yeah, and then go to, the more important thing is go to the planning board.
Yeah.
They're going to need this form all filled out. You're going to have to give it to them. So they'll go from there with it. But you want to get to the planning board so they get you on their agenda for Monday, because they don't meet until...
No, but they meet Monday, they're aware that
they're meeting this Monday, but
yeah, this has been filled out for about a month now.
Yeah,
so
their next meeting isn't until the 27th, I don't think, of the month of October. Yeah, I think their next meeting is the 27th of October. So, and, it'll be just the week before, 3 days before ours.
No, I think they're having one Monday night.
This Monday?
Yeah.
Yeah, but the next meeting is the 27th.
Right,
so if he doesn't get on this agenda, he don't go on the agenda until the 27th. And if there is an issue, they might be meeting in between, but
no,
I doubt it. They've
I
been
think,
meeting every 3 weeks.
Yeah, I think we were good for Monday, but we'll confirm that tomorrow.
Right, so you can get Jennifer to get it done and then get everything finalized. But you're going to have to get everything done between now and Monday for them, the drawings and all that. So you're going to have to get that taken care of. All right, so can we have a motion, please?
To continue the hearing?
Yes.
Yeah, so I'll make a motion to continue the hearing until next month.
March, October 29th.
October 29th meeting.
At 7:30.
At 7:30.
Okay. Second?
Second.
All in favor? Aye. All right, and you talk to Mark and he'll help you go along with it. And just the thing is, get it done. So you can, right. Yeah, well, I don't know. We didn't get put on the agenda, right? Why didn't we do it? I mean,
The timing.
The timing was because of our different way of our agendas were set.
I think the last meeting was at, Ron or something, and it got pushed out or something.
Yeah, we had, prior to the 17th, it was, yes, the 24th got canceled.
Whatever. So, but that's where we're at. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna take 1 minute and try to get a hold of Ms. Capello and see where we're at. Okay. We've continued the Park Central meeting now to a quarter of. I can't get a hold of Lisa on the phone, and she's not answering yet, nor she's got back to me yet. Mr. Petrie, is he around?
Okay. No problem with requesting a continuance of the 40B hearing.
Hold on 1 minute, please. Okay. Lisa's not going to make it. Okay. So, first thing is we need to make a continuance of the Park Central hearing.
And I have no problem with requesting a continuance of the Park Central.
Okay. I want to then put the continuance in the Park Central hearing on the October 29th agenda and put it on the agenda for 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock, yeah.
Okay? Because I'm going to switch things around here. So we have a motion for that?
Motion to continue to the October 29th agenda at 8 o'clock.
Okay. Second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor? Okay. The other issue then is what is your opinion on what you want to do with the use variance?
What is the for a point of order, what is the voting requirements of the board on a variance? Is it
four?
It's four, period. So yeah, if there were four members sitting, it would require all four.
Yes.
If there were five members sitting, it would require four or five.
Right, and we have one alternate. And as of our next meeting, the Board of Selectmen hopefully is going to appoint one more alternate so we get back on agenda with where we're at.
And Tom has recused himself from...
Because of the connection with Cumberland Farms and his representative of Cumberland Farms, he's excused us from... has excused himself from all of the issues on Park Central.
Then I would prefer that we also continue the variance hearing, hopefully till the 29th also.
All right. So then in lieu of this, I think this time it was done different because he hadn't done it. But now that the variance has been scheduled, I'd like to have a motion to put the variance on the agenda for 7 o'clock. So we can do that first. And then after the variance, wherever it goes, then we can do some final discussion on the 40B at the end of the evening.
Who's going to sit on that? Who will be the five people that will sit on that?
On what?
On the variance request.
There'll be the three of us. There'll be Lisa and what do you call?
Andrew.
Andrew? Okay.
Yes, he'll be seen. Those will be the four members. And that's brand new.
It's clean.
Okay.
It'll be five members.
Five. There'll be the three of us.
Yes.
Lisa Capello.
And Andrew.
And Andrew. And if for some reason somebody... If somebody else is not here, the Board of Selectmen are apparently going to appoint the new alternate. And even though he's new, if somebody's not here, they'll be able to sit. So there'll definitely be five members to sit on that date.
For this project, I believe we would prefer having five members hear the application.
All right. So we need a motion to continue until the 29th at 7 o'clock.
I make a motion to continue the use variance to the October 29th at 7 o'clock.
Okay.
I'll second that.
Yeah. All in favor? Aye. I apologize to the public, but there's no way that we can do this, and it happened very, very late this afternoon, and Lisa just texted me. I guess she's had to do some emergency things with her daughter on top of it, so I apologize. We have no further discussions. Anything?
Nope.
With the board? So I have a motion if we adjourn.
We'll make a motion to adjourn.
Second?
I'll second that motion.
All in favor? Aye.